Now, cancer rates in children have been increasing over the past 30 years, and some are convinced it's because of the artificial turf used on football and soccer fields.
Investigative reporter Selena Lewis joins us now with how this could be impacting our children in the area. Selena?
Well, it actually all started in Seattle, where one soccer coach said that she saw goalie after goalie getting diagnosed with rare blood cancers. And so she and now other people are sort of concerned that it might be the chemicals in the artificial turf that's causing this. Artificial turf. It's used everywhere, football fields, soccer stadiums, but many times we don't give this fake grass or what's in it too much thought.
I guess if it wasn't safe, they wouldn't have us playing on it, so I guess I trust in my school and my principals and my coaches.
But now some are questioning its safety after a soccer coach in Washington State compiled a list of around 30 soccer players who have developed rare types of blood cancer, saying around 22 of those are goalies, the players who spend the most time diving onto the turf. Doctors here in Amarillo say they are noticing a trend as well.
Over the last 3 decades, the cancer rates in children are increasing, and it's quite a bit. That's concerning. Although the cure rates are going up, more kids are being affected by cancer.
But Dr. Turner says he doesn't know why this is happening. He says most types of blood cancer are linked to genetics or certain viruses like Epstein-Barr. But that environmental factors could be contributing as well.
Benzene has been shown to cause some cancers.
Benzene and butadiene are both volatile organic compounds, or VOCs, and are used in the production of rubber tires. In large enough quantities, they have been linked to various types of leukemia.
Now, it's not the actual AstroTurf grass itself that some think is potentially dangerous, but what they use to fill in the AstroTurf to make it softer when athletes fall, which is this black crumb rubber, as it's called. And it's not just found in football arenas and soccer stadiums. It's found in children's playgrounds like Meadie Park here in Amarillo.
It's hard to tell an association versus something being causal.
The Environmental Protection Agency has yet to do a rigorous study on this link and refuses to comment, but studies conducted by the California government showed trace amounts of both benzene and butadiene in the crumb rubber used in AstroTurf.
I think it'd be money well spent to do the studies to look for any possible association with these products and leukemias or lymphomas.
The study done by the California Department of Resources and Recycling says there is added danger for exposure to benzene when the crumb rubber is exposed to heat, but that it has not been studied thoroughly enough.
I think if they are going to be putting this in schools around children, that they should definitely do the studies to make sure that it's not going to cause problems for them in the future.
Now, the Amarillo City Council on Tuesday just passed a bill saying that they would spend nearly $200,000 on a new turf for the Civic Center, but that it was a different kind of turf that didn't have the same crumb rubber.
Yep.
So we'll see.
All right. Thanks, Lily.
All right. Thank you.